Hey, hello. You can see I'm still not completely settled yet with my new room. You can see my 3D printers here in the back. But yeah, slowly we're getting there. But in this video, I want to actually talk about what's coming up for the CFD analysis videos. So we did quite a lot already, mainly for outdoor airflow. But there were some requests regarding indoor airflow and heat transfer and so on. And I want to give a preview and by what's actually already possible without my tutorials. There will be tutorials, but I'm still also like trying to figure out everything. But I want to show you that there are example files in the download folder for Butterfly. So whenever you download a Butterfly, you automatically have example files for wind analysis, indoor airflow, heat transfer, and more. So these are ready-made scripts, which normally should work. I haven't tested all of them, and that's what we do now. We're starting Rhino in admin mode, very important. All right. Also very important that we started in meter, so we always should use meter. And we start in Grasshopper. And they're not really what I like with Eddie3D. Eddie3D has this tool where you can just run the templates, which is super great. We don't have that, but we still have in Butterfly. We still have the folder where we have example files. So you can see here in the Butterfly download folder there is this folder called example files. There's an installer file, there's the outdoor airflow, indoor airflow, outdoor airflow 2D, which we haven't tried. I had some problems with that file. We have indoor airflow, so we can try that. And that's really great to learn if you are interested in that. Open the example files and they're ready to go, basically. Open file and this file is set up in meters, so if you're using a different unit, make sure to scale the input geometry. Understand? So that's what I always say. Use meter, please. Again, so I will not explain everything because we will do a tutorial about that, but it's very similar built than my previous tutorials and scripts, except for the create butterfly surfaces. So there's a bit of a difference. And that we will look into more detail, but we can still run that script and we can actually look at it, how it's set up. So it's a box with an inflow and an outflow. That's what I understood. But yeah, let's check here. Outlet boundary, yes. So we have inlet boundary, which is this one. We have a wall boundary, which is the box, and we have an outlet boundary. And instead of like building the wind tunnel from building the case from wind tunnel, we're actually building the crate case from geometry. That's basically what it is. And then you have the different types of surfaces. And you also need to specify the initial velocity for the inflow, but yeah, I think it's gonna be really cool. I am actually now looking forward to it. Purge case, that never worked for me for whatever reason. Maybe it works now, I don't know. But yeah, let's just run it. Builds a case, and then it's pretty much the same. So we're building a block mesh, and we're creating the snappy hex mesh. So we're building the snappy hex mesh. So it's very similar. And then we can actually look at the mesh. It's great that all is already set up. So instead of like having the object in the middle, now the boundary is actually having this finer mesh around. Let's turn it off, we don't need that. And funny thing is with these example files, there are lots of bits and bobs flying around, which are actually not connected to anything. I guess somebody just put something in and didn't clean it up at the end. I could also add a turbulent model here. Why not? And we can run a solution. And there is already a data in there. I don't know exactly why. Maybe I was running it already in the past. But yeah, you can actually see. Yeah, it's quite interesting. The airflow. and look from the side, kind of rotates back, so it comes out and it goes back. But let's rerun it. Again, it makes a lot of noise. Interesting that it runs very quick. It's almost at 1,000. Not sure if there's a limit set or not. Oh yeah, 5,000. Over there already. I think it stopped because it reached the target residual value. In any case, so you can see that it works. It also plots the residual somewhere. Yeah, it did. So it's all set up. It's pretty cool. I talked about residuals in one of the previous videos, and I guess it already stopped the calculation or the iteration because it already reached a certain target residual value. What we're actually measuring here, we have the pressure and the wind vector, the velocity. I'm not sure if... Oh yeah, also shows the pressure, but there's no... Oh yeah, yes. Guess I'm not 100% sure, and we will look at that, but I'm thinking this is the variation pressure to the normal atmospheric pressure. Pretty cool. So you can see, even you don't know anything about Butterfly CFD, you can actually run scripts because they're already ready made and ready for you. Okay, let's have a look at, let's close this one, let's open document, let's see what else is here. Pipe, the indoor airflow 2D, it's not really much different. You can look at it yourself, it's here, and let's do the pipe meshing. Really don't know what's going on here. Site Google, so there's also a description what this does. Okay, inlet, I want to see what's in there. Okay, and outlet. And outlet, so inlet, outlet, and here is similar. We have we're using the geometry, and we basically defining different boundary conditions. Pipe, okay, create case from geometry, butterfly update block mesh dictionary. So this is definitely different. Let's run that, and let's run this one, and this is again the snappy hex mesh. This interesting, I haven't seen that before, so that's gonna be interesting to look at. And also here the snappy hex mesh has additional code. Interesting. Okay, let's see if I can decipher what that's gonna be. Okay, and what, that's it? Seems like it's a non-complete script. Cylinder case. I mean, we can try to run that and let's see what it does. Okay. I guess one of the tutorials, we need to look at that. I will look at this and see how I can solve it. It's a challenge. Let's see. Let's close this. No, I don't need that. Okay. And then let's see what else is there. Atrium buoyancy. Okay. If there's temperatures are currently assigned by hand. Okay. Oh, we're loading a E+ weather file that goes into temperature inlet boundary. Okay. That's gonna be interesting. So we actually measuring how air, so this is a heat transfer recipe, I guess. Let's check. Yes. So it's about how the temperature, outdoor temperature goes inside the building. Oh, I'm very curious. This gonna be really interesting. Let's see. Okay, that worked. This is always pretty much the same. That was very quick. Makes me a bit worried. Snappy hex mesh, okay, let's see. That worked, okay. And then there's the simulation. I'm very curious how that's gonna look like? Let's see, preview this. Okay, so it's shows the heat transfer through the building via a section. Okay. Not sure how that works with the inlet, because temperature doesn't come just from one side. But we will find out all these things. Temperature, boundary wall, 29 degree, okay. So, okay, let's see what's coming up. It doesn't feel very well. Oh, okay. Okay, so there was a limit of 400, good. And it ran, but I'm not 100% sure what this actually all means. Oh wait, so there's a heat. Okay, now we're talking. Or do we? Yeah, that seems a bit of an issue. I mean, I understand that scripts might not be finished, but place it as an example file, although it's actually not finished. I don't get it. But yeah, so also something to find out. Interesting. Also something to find out how it works. So you can see there's a lot of different ways in how you can use that software. Now let's open the last one. And then next time we're gonna start with the indoor airflow, but let's have a look at the air condition. This file is set up in meters. If you're using a different unit, make sure to scale the input geometry. Yes. So meaning there's an air condition on the top outlet, okay. Inlet, where's the inlet? Ceiling and wasn't floors. Okay, all right. Let's see. Again, building a case from geometry, building the block mesh. That's all good. See, it's pretty much always the same strategy. Not sure about this thing here, but we'll know in a minute, I guess. This is again about heat transfer. End time is 1000 iterations. Okay. So we're building test points. Let's see what they are. So it's similar to the previous one. Pretty cool. Here's a problem with the okay, no, it's no problem. Look at the residuals also. You can see it's still changing. Here you can see the residual values going actually down. Normally you try to have a target value for each. And I think the solution stops whenever you reach the target values or the time limit. That's how I understand it. But yeah, pretty cool. Funny thing is that it's not really, is it really cool? Is it about cooling anyway? Seems like pretty cool. So I guess I hope that gives you something to play with before we actually jump in and try to rebuild these scripts. And then we go a bit more into detail on how they actually work. All right, so that's very interesting stuff coming your way and my way. And hey, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.